this AI business, it's just everywhere now. It's everywhere. It's the beginning of it, so it's going to get a lot more prevalent, and people are going to be talking about it more. And as a fine artist, a guy works with wood and paper and metal and all that kind of stuff. You know, I get asked all the time, you know, is this freaking you out, Tom? You worried about those robots doing all your work, thinking, oh, that's going to be crazy. You worried about that, Tom? No, not really. No. Yes. I mean, I think that you got to take it in. You have to, like, accept that it's reality and it's just going to happen. But what are you going to do about it? I mean, you got to find a way to integrate that into your daily sort of practice. What is happening here? Why is my chain is caught on the glasses? But, you know, you have to bring it into the fold, you know? It's like if someone's, like, walking around your peripheral of your yard and they're just crazy and they want to kill you, you let them in, don't you? No, what is that? Keep your enemies, keep your enemies close. No, keep your, it's the mobster thing. Keep your friends close and your enemies close. That's what it is. So the same with AI, you know, keep it close. Take it in, feed it, nurture it. Then, like those chimpanzees that people raise, they rip your face off. Then you're gone. That's it. Fine. Who cares? You're gone. No one has any idea what's going to happen. No one knows what's going to be AI, where it's going to land. It's impossible. It's impossible to know what's going to happen. No one knows. So what are we worrying about it for? Tom, if you don't worry about it and you don't pay attention to this, what's going to happen is that it'll sneak up on you. It'll take your job. It's going to take your job. Fine. Come on in. Come on in, AI. Come on in, robot. Take over. I'll just drink coffee and sit there and go, hey, can you kind of repaint that whole area there? Make that a Spanish kitty cat with a leopard back and wingspan of a gull, and see what it does to that. You'd be like,
I will do that. I will do.
They're not going to talk like that. They don't. That's a fallacy. There's no real robot going to be in my studio. We're talking about AI. Talking about artificial intelligence. Yeah, that's stuff that's on the computer. That's stuff that's in the sky. That's stuff that's you can't feel, touch, kiss, hug, ride. Can't do none of that with AI. It's in the cloud. Doesn't exist. That's what makes it even creepier. It's like a silent killer. Silent but deadly. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Who cares? I actually don't care. I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. I'm going to, I'll dabble in AI, you know, dabble in it, you know, part-time it, check it out. Hey, what's going on here? You know, pop into the AI club. Hey, what's happening, guys? What's going on here? They all look at me like, he ain't one of us. He ain't one of us. Good luck to you, artist. That's all I'm saying. I say check it out, but don't get too deep into it. And here's why. Here's why I say this. Because you lose your sense of doing art on your own, doing stuff. It's just going to get into like lazy prompting, you know? It's a Statue of Liberty dressed in a tuxedo in a swamp, you know, near the pyramids, suspended by 16 ants also dressed in scuba gear. Make it scuba gear. And they're all floating in the water as the Statue of Liberty salutes in like a Hitler salute. See something? Oh, let's get political. AI will kick that out and say like,
this is sexual, this is political, this is, you know, anti-Semitic, this is, you know,
because AI gonna censor you. You think you're putting those prompts in there and like, I can do whatever I want. No. You have more luck doing that in your own studio than putting it out into a prompt. A prompt is akin to saying a coach plays the game. Coaches coach. Coaches have some, you know, insight, but the players play the game. And if you're an AI guy and you're sitting back prompting, doing some prompts with my cappuccino, yeah, I did some prompts. Oh my God, you are the greatest prompter ever. You're such a creative prompter. Did you see what he wrote? It was so creative. What a prompter. What a prompter.
I ain't got no respect for that.
I mean, it's, I guess it's writing. And it's imagining, you imagine that. I imagine, I saw that in my brain. I saw those words in my brain. I could see it. But all these years, you didn't paint it. All these years, you didn't construct it and like make a little model and make the, and then make a film out of it. No. You waited till the computer would do everything for you. So, as you can see by my tone of my voice, I have some contempt and some disgust a little bit for lazy mofos. And if you allow AI to, you know, just to exist in your world because you're lazy and you want more time to like sit out there with a pina colada or just hang out or just, or even just work out so you can get like, you know, I've got abs now. Check it out, man. I'm in the gym like 17 hours a day. Fine. Yeah. And you're not doing any like real work. Not that working on your body's not real work. It is, but you know, we also need people, man. We need brains out there. You know, if you're really super smart, man, don't get all tied into the computer thing, man. Find ways to solve other problems. You know, agricultural problems, you know, climate problems, you know, building structure problems, medical problems. Use your brain to create and to advance civilization, not advance the computer. It's just a tool.
All right, that's all I gotta say for this.
Take care of yourselves. I love you more than dirt.